sensing COVID-19 days before symptoms appear. That's the goal of a wireless wearable technology local researchers are rolling out to frontline workers and those at greatest risk for the virus.
So this is our manufacturing areas.
It's a full-scale operation at Northwestern's Query Simpson Institute for Bioelectronics. On the production line, wearable sensors.
It's pretty much printed circuits. So it's kind of a printing process. You can think of it that way, similar process like you would screen print a t-shirt. You can screen print the components and put them in place on a flexible device.
Originally designed to monitor babies in the NICU, the small flexible sensors measure vital signs without cumbersome wires and leads. But when COVID-19 came to town, the research team tweaked their model to detect critical yet subtle early signs of the virus.
We're seeing in some COVID-19 patients, they cough 100 times or more per hour. You can think about how many respiratory droplets are being produced, but also a sign of whether they're actually getting better or not.
Dr. Steve Zhu showed us how it works. He was wearing a sensor during our interview. With each test cough, the counter ticked up. There are other key measurements. An EKG tracks not just heart rate.
So the ECG does much more than just heart rate. You're actually tracking heart arrhythmias that could be, you know, bad and detrimental.
There's a reading for respiratory rate, a helpful gauge for shortness of breath, and a separate pulse oximeter measures blood oxygen levels.
We know in COVID-19 there are certain patients that are silent hypoxemic patients, which means they have low blood oxygenation and they don't even know it.
The data is analyzed using artificial intelligence algorithms. The sensors are already in use among frontline workers and patients at Shirley Ryan Ability Lab and in some patients at Northwestern Memorial Hospital.
It's mechanically invisible. You can see how stretchy and flexible this is. Most of our users, the biggest compliment we get is that they forget they even have it on.
Tanya Adele O'Neill will never forget her struggle with COVID-19. The 53-year-old nurse was hospitalized for 2 weeks with just one lung. Her underlying condition put her at great risk for severe complications.
I just had that overwhelming feeling that I would not be coming back home, because by the time I got to the hospital, I was in very bad shape. I felt like someone just had a belt that was across my chest. And no matter how much I tried to inhale, I just could not get any, there was just no air that was transferring into the lung.
Now she wears the sensor as part of an ongoing clinical trial to validate the technology and to help progress the science she knows will lead to a better understanding of the virus.
The sensor gives me, it makes me feel a lot more comfortable being at home.
More than 1,200 COVID-19 patients have been treated at University of Illinois Health on the city's west side. Some employees of the hospital.
We have almost 7,000 employees here at UI Health. We hire employees that are from our community. We try very hard to do that. And so our employees look like the population we serve. Very diverse, but they also have some of the same risk factors that contribute to COVID-19 mortality.
That includes hypertension, diabetes, and lung disease. Chief Medical Officer Dr. Terry Vandenhoek partnered with the Chicago Medical Society to bring sensor technology to UI Health employees who test positive for the virus.
The issue that we are finding is that patients may have more symptoms than they realize. They may be sicker than they think. And we've had patients come in to our emergency department that have had very low oxygen levels and they didn't even realize it. Complete surprise. And we think that if they had known how sick they were a few days before, that we could have helped them and maybe even avoided an intensive care unit stay or have to even be on a ventilator.
Those who opt in while recovering from home receive the sensor kit from Fizz IQ, a local company that developed the artificial intelligence platform used to track a wide range of physiologic measurements in patients.
The way this works is the AI takes data from any wearable sensor, builds a personalized model for that patient so that we can compare them to themselves. That allows us to see very subtle changes in physiology. One of the advantages of using AI with a wearable sensor is we literally can see these changes before the patient even feels the symptoms.
And I'll make a prediction that, you know, in the future, you'll grab your keys, you'll grab your smartphone, and you'll grab your patch, and you'll be on your way.
The Northwestern team hopes to get FDA approval for their sensor system this fall, with the hope to roll it out to many more populations, including those living in assisted living facilities. And the Fizz IQ algorithm has other applications. It's used to track subtle changes in COPD and heart patients. We will keep you updated on both. Back to you.